kicks off for Arsenal in the league match against Villa wearing white shorts. Villa have brought in so much new talent that they are known as the Bank of England team, but they have yet to prove their sterling worth. Arsenal goes quickly ahead thanks to their centre-forward Drake, who has apparently decided to win the match on his own. Continuing his display of brilliant opportunism, he plays ducks and drakes with the Villa defence. Villa's expensive experts are unavailing, and Drake scores at regular intervals, getting two more in the first half. He gets seven, equaling the league record of 47 years standing. Here you are, Villa. Here is the man you want, Ted Drake.
Arsenal captain, Alec James. Outside right, Joe Hume. Centre-half, Herbie Roberts. Outside left, Clifford Bastin. Left half, Wilfred Copping. Centre forward, Ted Drake, little knowing that he's to be the hero of the day. Left back, Idris Hapgood. And goalie, Alec Wilson. And once again, all roads lead to Wembley. They say that 100,000 will pass through the turnstiles. And if anyone's got a ticket that he isn't going to use, a few thousand others will want to know the reason why. Every street is a moving stream of favour-wearing fans, mostly in a hurry. But wouldn't it be much nicer to go to the cup final like this? And now take your seat in the Pathé Autogyro and see Wembley as you've never seen it before. That's Mrs. Jones, second from the left. The fight is on. We're facing the Arsenal goal, with Sheffield United attacking strongly in the great ding-dong struggle which makes up the first half. First 29 minutes of the second half, it's the same story. The fierce to-and-fro struggle with neither side scoring. But at last, Bastin passes to Drake. Drake streaks through the Sheffield defence and Arsenal are one up. So the 1936 Cup final comes to an end. And Arsenal bring the Cup southwards for the second time in their career. And Pathé Gazette offers them its heartiest congratulations. Like a million ants, the huge crowd streams homeward.
Thank you. Chelsea the champions, and here they come taking the field at Stamford Bridge for the match against Sheffield Wednesday, which put them at the top of the first division in their Jubilee year. Remember those jokes about the pensioners? No more of those now. Watch those boys go. The first one comes from Parsons' head. And doesn't that head get a ruffling by his jubilant teammates? A penalty goal by Sillett. A third goal by Parsons soon after, and it's all over. Chelsea, for the first time in their career, are top of the league. And here's the man who did it, Ted Drake, the manager, the unyielding coach, the welder of team spirit. Ted, Roy Bentley, and the rest of the first team in the first division. Well done, Chelsea.